Welcome to Zapier. Whether you're new or an expert in automation, you've come to the right place. Over the next 14 days, you are going to learn the ins and outs of Zapier as we follow along with the star of the show, Zoe, a new taco truck owner. She is going to use Zapier in every part of her business. She's going to automate customized emails that get sent every day, lead systems she builds for catering and taking online orders. We'll see how she builds support chatbots to help her with customer questions. She'll automate social media management, employee onboarding that automates tons of actions with just a click of a button. And all this Zoe built and automated in Zapier. You see, Zoe doesn't want to get bogged down in the day-to-day. She wants to focus on making the best taco. I'm going to go to this taco truck. This taco truck's going to be well-oiled. Now, this isn't just about Zoe. You are going to be following along with us. And thankfully, Zoe has so graciously shared everything she's built. So you're going to be able to steal these templates with just a click of a button. So every night, Zoe has a checklist for her business the next day. But there's one thing missing. She wants tomorrow's weather forecast to be included in that checklist she gets because she knows when it's sunny, more people eat tacos. So the first order of business is to create a Zap. I'm going to show you exactly what Zoe built to make this happen. Zoe clicks Create Zap, and that opens up the Zap editor. The first thing she does is go down into Copilot and just types out what she needs. Every night, check tomorrow's forecast and send me a checklist reminder email. She'll click Enter, and Zapier will suggest the perfect outline for her first Zap. Let's click to put all these steps into the Zap. Once we do that, we can see that the Zap has been set up. Then we'll close Copilot out and take it from here. We'll just adjust the time of day we want this to start. 7 p.m. looks good. Yeah, we'll trigger it on the weekends. We'll click continue, and then you just test the trigger. Make sure it's working correctly. We'll just continue with that. And then there's that Weather by Zapier app. You can get tomorrow's forecast. That looks good. We'll click continue. And again, test the step. We scroll down and we can see that it gives us a summary. It has summary, field, scattered clouds, hot, maximum temperature, minimum temperature. The last step is to just send the email. Email by Zapier is the app. We're going to choose send outbound email. This gets sent to Zoe, and here's where we can type up what Zoe's going to read every single day. If we want to include the forecast, we have to do something called mapping. All that is where one step hands off information to another step. So we'll type in here tomorrow's forecast. Then you can add in that information from step two. We'll go down, insert the summary, and we'll say the high is that max temperature. All right, you got this, Zoe. We'll click continue, and then you'll test that step as well. This Zap is ready to go. Click publish. And now every night at 7 p.m., Zoe's gonna get tomorrow's checklist email in her inbox with that forecast. Steal this Zap for yourself. We're gonna include a template so you can set it up and get that daily reminder email. Next up, we're gonna see how Zoe expands. She's gonna start taking online orders and get leads for the catering part of her business. She's gonna build it all and automate it all in Zapier. I'll show you how she did it and more in the next video. I'll see you there.